Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we'll learn how to assign the leaders and queue leaders in AutoCAD. So let's see. Now we'll see how to assign the leaders and queue leaders in AutoCAD using the leader and queue leader commands. So let's go in AutoCAD. I'll just click on the start drawing to create a new tab. Now here I will draw some sketch. Suppose I am drawing two circles. I'll draw one rectangle. Also draw one triangle using the line command. Now let's see how to assign the leaders. Basically, leader is to assign the text with the arrow. So I'll just go in the leader command. So for that, enter LEA, press enter command. It is asking to specify the start point. So I'll just specify the start point. It is asking to specify the next point. So I'll just click here for the next point. Now again, we can take another next point. Suppose I want this first number of points. So I'll just press enter. Now it is asking to specify the line of annotation text, that is our first line. So suppose I am just entering AutoCAD, I'll just press enter. Now it is asking me to enter the next line of annotation text, so I'll just enter the next text. Suppose I am entering computer. And if this much line of annotation text is enough, then I'll just press two times enter to exit the command. See, like this our text will be shown with the arrow. So like this you can use the leader command. Now we'll see how to use the queue leader command. So for that, press Q L enter. Now here also it is asking to specify the first point of the leader. So I'll just specify this as my first point. I'll click on the next point. Here also I will click for the next point. Now you can see here there is one option different from the leader, that is asking to specify the text width. So here we can specify the text width according to our need. Suppose I am specifying the text width at 3. We'll just press enter. Now it is asking to specify the line of annotation text. So I can enter anything. If I want to enter another text, I'll just press enter. See, like this it will show me the text with the given height. Suppose I want to give leader of another height, so I'll again go in the queue leader, press enter. Suppose I will take the leader on this point. Now here I will take the text height as 6, press enter. I'll just enter the text, press enter. Now again you want to enter the another text, so you can enter the text, and to exit the command, press 2 times enter. Like this you can enter the text. So here basically the heights are different for the text. Like this you can change the text height using the queue leader command. Now we'll see the various settings in the queue leader. So for that we'll again go in the queue leader command. For various settings we'll just go and click on this settings. Now here basically we are using this first type, that was M text, because we are entering the text with the leaders. Now here this second option, that is leader line and arrow. So here basically we can select while our line is straight or it has to be curved using the spline command. So we can select either which we want. Now here we can select the arrowhead style, that is we want close field or any different symbol for the arrow. We can select from here. It is asking to the number of maximum points, so I can maximum enter 3 number of points. Now here we can specify the angle constraint. Now here I am drawing the line at any angle, but if you want to add some constraint angle, so you can add from here according to the first and second segment, because the number of limited points are 3. Next option is attachment. So here basically it is asking for the placement of the text, so we can select either of this option for the placement of the text. If the text is on the right hand side, we can select either option from this, and if it is on the left hand side, we can select either option from this 5 options. And if you want to underline the text, you can just tick here. It will underline the text in the leader. So like this you can change the settings. Now we'll see another setting, that is copy an object. So I will just click here, press OK. Now I'll again go in the QLeader. So I'll go in the QLeader command. I'll just take this. See, now it is asking to select an object to copy. Suppose I want this same text to be here, so I'll just click on this text. See, the same text has been copied here. So like this we can use copy an object in QLeader command using the settings. Again we'll go in the QLeader, we'll see the next setting. So again click on the setting. Now third option is of tolerance, so I'll just click OK. So with use of this we can enter the tolerances with the given leader. In just dimension we are assigning only the geometric tolerances box but without the leaders. So here we can apply tolerances with the use of leaders. So I'll just select the symbol. Suppose I want to show this line as parallel, so I'll just click here. I'll give the tolerance as 0.02. I'll take some material condition, just click OK. See, like this we can assign the tolerances with the help of this leader. Now we'll see the last settings, that is none. So here basically we can just simply enter the leader without any text. See, we can just simply enter the leader, and if you want to add some text you can simply use the mtext command and you can enter the text here whichever you want in your leader command. Suppose I want to show here diameter of 100, so I can just enter the leader. I will go in the mtext command, I will select here. I'll just go in the symbols, I'll select the diameter symbol, it will take the diameter as 100. Just select this and increase the text height to say 4 and click on the close text editor. The height has been increased more, so I will just reduce it. I'll just select and take the text height as 0.5. Like this we can assign the leader and the text using the mtext command. I will just move this. See, like this we can assign the leaders and QLeader command in AutoCAD. Thank you friends for watching this video.